Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to look into how to configure Hazelcast caching with the Spring Boot application. So if you go to the Spring Boot official website, then you'll get the Hazelcast link over here. Let's click over here. Then we have navigated over here. So in earlier video tutorial, we have seen how to configure InfiSpan with Spring Boot application. In this video, we are going to look Hazelcast. Now, saying that Spring Boot has a general support for Hazelcast, and click over here, then and open a new tab. Then they have given the complete details, saying that if Hazelcast is on the class path, Spring Boot will auto configure Hazelcast instance that you can inject in your application. The Hazelcast instance is only created if the configuration is found, right? You can configure your config file bin, and you'll use if your configuration defines an instance name, right? You'll try to locate an existing instance rather than creating one. So if you have already configured a bin for Hazelcast, then that will be used as default will be auto configure, and that may be used. You can also specify hazelcast.xml configuration file to use via configuration, right? So you can, if you don't want a Java based configuration, then you can specify XML file. You can create XML file and Hazelcast information you can put in this XML file, and that location you can specify in your application.property by using this property, right? So that's all. Now come to the Eclipse and let's see how we can integrate it with the Spring Boot application. So this is the project which we have seen in the previous video tutorial, which is related to InfiSpan cache. I'm going to make another copy of this project with different name, and I will give Spring Boot Hazelcast cache. Now let's click on OK. Now let's I'm going to close all my previous projects. Okay, and this is the project which we have created. Now basically Hazelcast is a distributed in-memory data grid tool and can be used as a caching provider for the Spring Framework abstraction caching layer. Using caching, you can improve the overall performance of your application. In the following video, we'll demonstrate how to configure Hazelcast caching with Spring Boot. And if you want Hazelcast to be in action, then first change you will have to do, I'm going to specify 6, that is the latest one, 156. And here, first of all, I'm going to replace this dependency which we had added in previous video for InfiSpan with Hazelcast. So that I'm going to replace like this. So these two dependency will have to add if you want a Spring Boot integration with Hazelcast, right? So we use Maven to manage our project dependencies. To start, add this following dependency to your project, right? So these are two dependency for Hazelcast. Once you are done with this, then Hazelcast caching configuration. If Hazelcast is on the class path, as I said, Spring Boot will auto configure the Hazelcast instance that can inject in your application. Hazelcast instance is only created if the configuration is found. In this example, I will show you how to configure it using the Java based configuration, right? So what you will have to do, now go to the your properties file, go to the resources properties, and here you can see we have given the cache type as InfiSpan, which we have written in previous video. So let's replace with the Hazelcast. This is not necessary, this entry is not necessary, still I'm gonna specify. Now if you have a Hazelcast support, then here you can see if you are going for the Hazelcast XML base configuration, then this gives you opportunity to configure those things as well. Hazelcast config, and that location you can provide, but we are going to look Java based configuration, right? So what I'll do, so I'll create a config file in my this directory. So let's go to create a first of all my package in .config, and I have already written that class, which configuration class. Even you can see I have annotated this class as configuration, and I have given the class name as Hazelcast config. I have configured one bin. This we could have done in our bootstrap class as well. Here also you can configure this bin, but I have created a separate configuration file, Java based configuration, and here you can see I am setting the Hazelcast name, and I have given the Hazelcast cache name, right, which we have specified. That's why I said this is not required at all. So that is optional. If you specify the Hazelcast cache name here, then entering in properties file is optional. Now we are specifying the Hazelcast size, right, and we have given the policy, right, eviction policy. What eviction policy is Hazelcast going to use? So here we have given the LRU. LRU is a cache eviction algorithm called least recently used cache. We have also, you can also specify LFU, and LFU is a cache eviction algorithm called least frequently used cache, right? So by looking into the name itself, you understand what says this algorithm, right? And we have given the time to live in seconds. So 2000 seconds I have specified. If you divide by the 60, then we get that much seconds your data will be in the cache. So as per your project requirement, you can set your these properties. Now once you are done with this, now you are ready to go. Now Hazelcast is integrated with Spring Boot application. Now how we can test it? Now if you go to the database, then currently you can see there are 4 records in my database. Database name is Spring Boot DB. And let me explain. This is our bootstrap class. Here we have enabled caching in our application by specifying enable caching. Now this is already we have discussed. We have a controller. There we have a method to get ticket information based on the ticket ID. Then second method, if you want to delete ticket information from the underlying database, then delete ticket. And finally we have a update ticket information. I mean basically update ticket that person email ID based on the specified ticket ID. And we have auto wire our service class over here. If you go to the service class, then we have we made use of the DAW, which we have injected, and DAW is just simply I have created an interface that is extending CRUD repository, and CRUD repository basically provides you some basic method to perform the CRUD operation. This is the way to create a DAW interface in Spring Data JPA. If you don't know about how to work with the Spring Data JPA, then you can watch my previous videos. Now here we are basically we are fetching the record based on the provided ID, right? We are deleting records from the blank database by provided ID, and we are deleting person email address based on the provided ID. And here we are trying to use the cache at rate. Cacheable means when first time this method will be called, and return type will be cached in the cache with this key, right? If this method returns null, then this is not gonna cache. That's what we have unless attribute. And cache name, whatever you have given in the your configuration file, that same cache name you will have to specify over here, right? So we have given the cache name in configuration file, same cache name will have to specify over here, right? Now second method we have a @rate cache evict. So if some entry if you are deleting from the database and that entry is already present in the cache, then that you will have to evict, that entry will have to delete also. So that's what. And if you want to update some record on the database side, then that data is suppose already in the cache, then you might be interested to update that data in the cache as well, right? So that's what we have a @rate cache put, right? So I hope you understood. Now let's run this application. So I'm gonna run this application. Now see, Hazelcast system, Hazelcast instance is created. Basically, Hazelcast maintains a lot of multiple nodes to replicate data, same data on the multiple nodes. So this advanced concept we are not going to learn here. We are basically going to focus how to integrate Hazelcast with the Spring application. Now, if you go to here in browser and if you try to hit, so we have already API I have listed over here in this API. So I am going to try to retrieve a ticket information based on the provided API, right? So here I'm going to specify ticket ID 1. Now see, select query has been fired. Let's see what happens. Yes guys, one mistake we have done. Guys, if you are working with the Hazelcast, then your entity class must implement serializable interface, as this is going to break, right? So because Hazelcast supports for distributed caching as well, so your Hazelcast must implement caching, serializable, as this is going to be fail. This error will get at runtime. So I'm going to implement serializable, and you can add generated serial version ID. And after making this change, let's rerun. Now at this time, this should run perfectly fine. Now here is the R bootstrap class. Let's run. So if you are working with the your Hazelcast, then your model class or entity class should implement serializable interface, as this is going to now our application has started with 80 port, and if you hit this URL, then now at this time we got the result, right? And have another trigger, select query, now ask for the ticket information whose ID is 2, then we got the information, like Hibernate has triggered query. Now what happened, we'll go to the API, is called matrix. So this is the basically URL which is exposed by the actuator in dashboard, and here you can see the size of your cache here, that is saying that's 2, right? So if you, here is my postman, and here I'm going to delete user information with ID 1, and after that we'll check the what is the cache size, right? So let's select delete and let's try to delete it. So that was supposed to, whose ID is 1 from database, saying that 200, okay. If you go to the database and refresh it, then ticket information with ID 1 is deleted. And now if you go and check the cache size, then that was supposed to be 1, right? So now cache size is showing as 1. So that means this cache is working perfectly fine, right? So I hope you enjoyed learning this video. This code I'm going to put on the GitHub, and GitHub location you'll get in the video description. If you have any questions or any query, then please do post below to the video. And here I'm not gonna show you how to configure this file. Let me delete from classpath because this was for infinite span. So you can try yourself how to configure Hazelcast by using XML configuration file. Here we have seen Java based configuration, right? So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.